Hello everyone, and welcome back to Fallout New Vegas. Now, my audio quality should be better since I bought a new microphone, but never know. But I am terribly sorry for the bad audio quality of my last two videos. Please forgive me. And, as an apology, I'll just go right back into playing. Just a still, that's a sad hole. Well, I was told to go this way. And of course I pull out a gun that has no ammo. Yeah, that should work for a while. At least until I find something better. Ooh, that's interesting. This is a shotgun. Here's the bathtub where we found Mr. Jones. Well, then that could have gone better. You know, I think I found this in my inventory. I don't know, guys. It's one of those game guns that they gave me at the beginning of the game. And, I don't feel like cheating. That's why I'm not wearing the really good armor that it tries to start you off with. Quick saving. What's this down here? I can take these cans if I want, but I don't know why I would. Powder ganger. Dang, I'm too far away for the shotgun to do too much damage. Oh, he's a barter? Wait, so you're a good guy? I thought you were a bad guy.
Hello? Can you help me?
What's wrong?
My girl is trapped by geckos on the ridge, and I can't get to her. Please, she's going to die.
Where is she?
Go up the path, past the broken radio tower, and go to the right. They're at the top of the trail.
I'll see what I can do.
You will? Thank you for helping me. Please hurry.
I feel like I should continue with the quest that I'm given. I think I'm finished. Oh, Oh, you know what? I almost forgot something. Since it's almost nighttime out and I do not like the night, I am going to sleep in this guy's bed if you'll let me. Because sleeping in beds allows you to heal your broken bones. My Johnny. Maybe you're cold. But it's a fresh new day. Ooh, Vicky and Vance Casino. I was always a fool. Ooh. Was that just a random encounter then? But if you stay, I love you. Okay. What if you're cruel? It's always good to quick save. Why is it gonna have no spikes on it? It says if there's an enemy in this direction. Ew, what an ugly thing that was. Jalapeno. I hear gunshots. Fast travel. Yep, I can go back to...
Hey, where the hell do you think you're going? Primm is off limits.
What's going on in Primm?
Some convicts from the prison up the road have taken over the town. Everyone inside is either dead or in hiding. What's more, there are two tribes of raiders causing trouble in this area as well. You'd be safer heading back up to Good Springs.
Well, shouldn't you be protecting this town? You
we
are an
to.
NCR
they
trooper.
They don't fall under NCR jurisdiction. Even if they did, we're in no shape to protect them.
Why can't you protect them?
We don't have the equipment to take out the convicts. And even if we did, we need some extra hands for backup. You should talk to Lieutenant Hayes. He's in a tent down the road. Just stay on the west side of the overpass if you don't want to get shot.
Ew. West. Okay. I forget which side. Wait, I got a compass. West side, okay. Ammo. Looking good in you? I don't even have a 10mm pistol. have lost karma. I'm sorry, but I need this stuff. I'm gonna have to fix my karma later. Because karma can actually make things a little harder for me. Because I am not a bad person, so... You know, I don't want to go through the bad routes.
Patrolling the Mojave almost makes you wish for a nuclear winter.
Haha, very funny. Yes, that's all I needed right now.
I'm Sergeant McGee of the New California Republic Army, 5th Battalion, 1st Company. If you want to talk about something, speak to Lieutenant Hayes.
Where are you from?
I'm from the Hub originally, but it's been a long time since I saw it. I'm on my second tour here. Most non-commissioned officers are.
Goodbye.
Sir.
I'm Lieutenant Hayes of the New California Republic Army, 5th Battalion, 1st Company. What's your business?
What are you doing out here?
We were sent out here to hold back the tide of convicts from the correctional facility. As you can probably tell, we aren't doing the kind of job we could be doing.
What's the problem with your mission?
The mission isn't a problem. The problem is with supplies. The convicts are better armed and organized than our intel initially suggested. I'm trying to get some reinforcements here, maybe some guns with some firepower, but shit. Things are just going slow.
Do you have any information on these convicts?
Not much. They've taken to calling themselves powder gangers, mostly because they've taken to using the explosives meant to clear boulders as weapons. They got organized faster than I would have thought, most of them at least. Thankfully, the small group in town here seemed to have split off from the main force, so they aren't getting anything in the way of support.
Tell me about this correctional facility.
Most people just call it NCRCF. That's NCR Correctional Facility. A little bit ago, the convicts there staged a coup, killed the guards that weren't able to escape, and have been ransacking the area since then.
It's horrible. I got other questions.
I have some free time. Ask away.
Well, I guess I don't have any other questions. Goodbye, Lieutenant.
Sir.
Morning.
Yep, I can't take these guys' ammo. I really feel bad for taking their ammo, but what am I gonna do? Hand it back to them saying, hey, I stole your ammo. No hard feelings, right? Whoa. Now I'm over encumbered. To the town of Alfrey, who rode a train to one fine day. Here's your landmines back, folks. Hardly spoke to folks around him, didn't have too much to say. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them had a bigger noise. Hip. Bigger notice. It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. From the south side, slowly looking all around. He's an outlaw. Wait, give me my arrow. Came the whisper from each lip, and he's here to do it. A big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. Oh, that's it for all that. Gun. In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas Red. And that many men were dead. Shotgun's not gonna be any good at this range. Let me repair that.
He came here to take an outlaw back to life, or he may be dead. And he said he didn't know where he was at. After Texas Bay.
But did you think that you could just hide there?
Was long before the storm, we left Texas Bay. But the outlaw didn't go to drive the former day.
Man, I need better weaponry.
20 men had made a slip. 21 would be the ranger with a big iron on
another varmint rifle.
Big iron on his hip. The morning passed so quickly it was time for them to meet.
Ugh.
It was 20 past 11 when they walked out in the street. Folks were watching from
Wait.
The windows. Everybody held their breath.
Give me very much armor.
About to meet his death.
What am I wearing? No ammo rating! I don't want to wear tribal armor. Weapons. I do not need spears.
And the ranger's aim was deadly with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip.
Oh, and I also got several varmint rifles.
It was over in a moment and the folks had gathered round. There before them lay the body of the outlaw on the ground. Oh, he might have won
on the ground. Let's just explore this building first.
When he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip.
I don't know what it was brought you to Primm, youngster, but you might want to rethink your plans. Town's gone to hell.
Who are you?
Johnson Nash is my name. Husband to Ruby Nash. Lived in Primm going on 8 years now, thick and thin. I'm a trader primarily, for what it's worth with things like they are. I also run the local Mojave Express outpost.
I'm a courier of the Mojave Express.
Well, I don't got any work right now, sorry to say.
I lost the package I was supposed to deliver.
I'll tell you whatever I can. You have a delivery order you can show me?
Can you tell me about this job?
Oh, you're talking about one of them packages. That job had strange written all over it, but we couldn't turn down the caps.
What's so strange about it?
That cowboy robot had us hire 6 couriers. Each was carrying something a little different. Pair of dice, chess piece, that kind of stuff. Last word I had from the office, it looked like payment had been received for the other 5 jobs. Guess it was just your chip that didn't make it. First deadbeat we hired to do the job, canceled. Hope a storm from the divide skins him alive. Well, that's where you came in.
Canceled.
Yeah, got this look when he saw you next down on the courier list. His expression turned right around. Asked me if your name was for real. I said, sure as lack of rain, you were still kicking. Then he turned down the job, just like that. I asked if he was sure it was good money. No, let Courier 6 carry the package. That's what he said. Like the Mojave'd sort you out or something. Then he just up and walked out.
Do you know who he was or where he went?
No idea. Sounds like you two had a history for him to act like that. And turn down the money, too. Hope he didn't see any trouble in that package of yours. Maybe he thought your name was bad luck. Enough for me to say.
Some men stole my package. A man in a checkered suit and some thugs. Did they pass this way?
Well, now that you mention it, a few nights back, one of the townies was out scavenging for supplies. He said he saw a fellow with a daisy suit come through with some of them Great Khan misfits. They was talking about a chip.
One of those men shot me. I need to know the best way to get to them.
Well, for that, your best bet is going to be talking to Deputy Beagle. Since they came to town, he was keeping a good bit of notes on them, and he was slinking around Bison Steve when your pretty boy friend came through. He may have heard where they were going.
I'd like to ask you about something else.
I guess I don't have anywhere better to be.
Caravan. Oh, I guess I should
have. You think you have what it takes, kid?
I actually learned how to play this game. Okay, play caravan. Choose it.
Hey, youngster.
They have anything for sale? Well, I have it, but I'm no good at it, I guess. Well, I don't want to sell my body pins. I need. Venom. That gives me some health. I don't want to sell that. I need ammo, not Johnson. Well, what about weapons actually? 10 mil, 9mm machine gun. No. 7 damage versus my 8 damage. Well, I guess it does do more damage, but no. I couldn't. Do you sell any 9mm ammo? Ooh, what's this do? Gun condition. Damage. Eh. hollow points. Hey. With 357 magnum rounds. And what kind of shotgun does my big caravan, what kind of ammo does my caravan and rifle take? 20 gauge. Guess that'll be it.
Thanks.
Wait, is that a quest? I mean, I don't think I'll be able to survive this, but some of those things actually gave me some negative effects, let's just say. Yes. Ooh, a stim pack. Those things are really useful. I need more lockpicking skill to get to that. Whoa, where are you? You're gonna have heartaches by the number, my good sir.
Had enough.
You done straight.
Had enough.
Flamer, the incinerator. That sounds fancy. And Nicola. For every day you love me less, each day I love you more. Yes, I've got heartaches by the number. I love, I cannot win. But the day that you stop counting is the day my world wins. Wait, Mentax? Ooh, fancy. And I need to repair all my weapons.
Play it again, my Johnny.
I got a really good varmint rifle.
But you're so warm.
Well, I can't let you out yet.
I was always a
I need to eat some of these things. Crispy squirrel bits.
Johnny guitar.
Oh.
I don't suppose you came here to rescue me. I'd cross my fingers, but my hands are not.
You must be Deputy Beagle.
Why, yes, I am. It's a pleasure to meet you. I'm in a bit of a predicament here. I'd be most appreciative if you'd set me free.
Sure, I'll set you free.
Oh, that's just marvelous. I think I'll be...
Sure, run away. You don't look like you'll be...
Then I'll defer...
Johnny Guitar. There's an upstairs I kind of want to clear out. Ooh, I can use that new weapon I found off that guy. Don't this just look like it fits out here? No, it doesn't. I've got too much dynamite in my hand.
Had enough.
A burn, breaking your pound. Oh, you shouldn't have given me this. He's an outlaw loose and running, came to whisper from each lip, and he's here to do some business with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. Oh, you really shouldn't have, game. In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas. Many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead. So I'm gonna drop all this dynamite and turn around. Nothing good can come of it. Now the stranger started talking, made it plain folks around. Was an Arizona Ranger, wouldn't be too long in town. He came here to take an outlaw back alive, or maybe... Oh, you're moving so slow. It didn't matter, he was after Texas Red. After Texas Red. This guy needs all that alcohol. Wasn't long before the story was relayed to Texas Red. But the outlaw didn't worry, man, to try it before we're dead. Ow. After tag, the save box, boring, medicine, bobby pin. I mean, I have to use a bobby pin to get in there, so. I don't have any repair skill. It was 20 past 11 when they walked out in the street. Ooh, rhyming. Folks were watching from the windows, everybody held their breath. They knew this handsome ranger was about to... Come on. deadly with the big iron. Oh, there's two of them. Big iron on his heel. An old cowboy hat. Oh boy. I can shoot fast too, you know. Welcome to level 3. I like my speech. With just a wee bit of bartering. When he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. Stim pack. A vomit rifle. Ooh, key. In this here. And this place was like a hotel or something. Answer note. Gun cabinet. Ooh, 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 look at this, guys. This is a submachine gun that's a laser gun at the same time. So I can go pew pew, but really fast. Anything special on you? Oh, jet? I mean, I don't like using drugs in this game. So, yeah, I usually sell them. Unless I truly need one. A bonnet? Of course! Yeah. Well then, Well, I think I know what happened here. Well, I'm sure someone will want to stick themselves with those 100-year-old needles. Sorry, my voice cracked. Those 100-year-old needles. Since, you know, that was before the war. The atomic war. Why do you think everything's all destroyed? That is true. You found someone new. Oh, love is true. Then you found someone new. Man.
Well, that was quite an adventure. We taught those convicts a thing or two, didn't we? Breaking myself out of a hostage situation. Not to diminish your role in it,
of course,
but it was quite thrilling. Problem is, there's still no law in Primm. What are we to do the next time ruffians menace us and hold us hostage?
Can you tell me about the man in the checkered suit who came through?
Ah, yes. My memory is much clearer now that I'm free from my bondage. I was performing recon, gathering information on some of the powder gangers, when some great cons arrived with your friend in the suit. They were talking about some delivery they took from a courier. I assume that was you. They said they'd be heading through Nipton to Novak to meet a contact there.
Okay.
Hello again.
What are you talking about? You're the sheriff now.
Oh, no. I'm just the deputy, and I can't be a deputy without a sheriff. It's called chain of command.
Ugh. What are the qualifications for sheriff?
It should be someone brave like you, but more of a homebody. Someone who'll settle down and watch over us. I heard the powder gangers talking about someone in the prison named Myers who has some experience as a sheriff. He may be a good choice. Also, with the NCR so close by, you may be able to get them to take over the town. Not sure why they haven't helped out already.
Well, I'll help bring law and order back to the Primm, I guess.
You will? That's just marvelous. I'll start thinking up questions for the interview. The sheriff that was incarcerated up at NCRCF may be a good choice. You also may be able to convince that NCR guy across the road to take the town under his wing. Although martial law doesn't sound so fun.
Hello? Whoa, the vodka's wore off. Well, that reminds me, actually. Where is that old man? That's the Eagle. Johnson, yeah, it was you.
Hey, youngster. Still.
So. Money. I got lots of things I could sell in here. Pre-war hats. No. No. Oh, this protects more than this does. I mean, pre-war, whatever. And I also had some, beverages for you to buy. Oh, I don't... I'll keep those in those. You never know. That should be enough for now.
Thanks.
Hey there.
Well, I don't feel quite right about Oda going into the air people that hate me. I don't know. I shot a bunch of powder gangers, so I don't think that they'd be able to be reasoned with. Not to mention, I don't want a bunch of sticks of dynamite thrown at me. That don't sound too pleasant. Okay, what does it take for you guys to put this place under martial law?
Oh, no.
Hello?
Yeah?
Primm is in dire need of some martial law.
We know Primm is a great strategic point, and we aren't blind to the needs of the town, but we're barely holding our own against the powder gangers. We don't have the guns or the personnel needed to carry out our mission, much less take on defending this town as well.
What do you need to take over protecting the town?
What we need more than anything is bodies. If we had just one more squad, we could easily install a sheriff and still handle our primary objective of protecting the interstate south of here. If you'd like to see the NCR include protection of Primm and its duties, then you'll have to get some more troops up here. Knight at Mojave Outpost may be able to help.
Well?
Have you gotten us any
Well, guess I'll have to go down to the Mojave Outpost. Where's that? Mojave Outpost, right here. So I suppose it's not too far out of the way. Ugh, I hate accidentally turning on the code of the game. It's just a big waste of time, you know. I think that statue up over there is where I'm going. I don't look too far away now that I think about it. Ooh. You know what? A highway going between two major outposts. I see enemies. Ooh. It's a sin, my farmer rifle has the best range. Because I know where are you? That's a convict. Sneak attack. The dream I built for us has tumbled. Each promise like my heart. Oh boy. I thought this farm rifle would be kind of bad, but it's seeing some good use here. Corn. Who's shooting? It's a sin. Who? Someone off in the distance there. I don't miss you when people know I'm still in love with you. I don't see anyone. I'm sure. Maybe just that blind is a bat or that they're wearing some sort of. Aha, I see him. Glitching into the wall.
Whoa, careful.
In the shadow of the valley. I would like. No, I'm just gonna count my blessings.
Wide open space.
I'm pretty sure that person is supposed to come out and shoot me.
Wind on my face. A
distant horizon. Walking around in the beginning of the game, especially since I can't teleport around. This is a baby one. Well, that's all my laser ammo, I suppose. Time again, I just stood there for 12 hours. Man, my legs must be incredible if I could stand up for 12 hours. Just saying, I gotta have some levels of, you know, leg strength. That's empty box. This gun will aid me. Trusty gun if you think about it. Oh, you scared me.
Howdy.
Mercenary. What are you doing, sir?
Hey there. Need anything?
Okay, let's see what I can sell him. Yeah. Collecting a lot of weapons that, you know, I don't need. Man, 340 caps. Oh wait, it says it's worth 624. Trying to cheat me out. Today my world will end. Ooh, how much for yourselves? Oh, only three. I thought there were seven each. Metal helmet? Yeah, that looks ugly. What's this? Plasma? I think this is for the plasma gun. Tri-beam laser rifles? Wow.
I waited, but you might.
I don't want anything else. Troubles by the score. Every day you love me less. Each day I love you more. Yes, I've got heartaches by the number. A love I cannot win. But day I've not counting. Today my world will end. And get this, to continue getting after that guy that shot me, I'm gonna walk all the way back down this hill. Oh, that reminds me.
Looking for trouble?
No, I'm only looking around.
Well, keep those eyes up and turning, or I'll set them spinning. Got no time for gawkers, or anyone looking for something I ain't selling.
How about a drink?
All right. Drinking to forget, and it's only getting me mad instead. Whiskey always gets my temper up, now more than ever. Drinking used to cause all sorts of trouble back west. Before I punched enough people, that is. And they learned to lay low when the whiskey hit.
What are you trying to forget?
Lost my caravan heading north. The driver burned to ash. And they didn't even take the cargo. They just burned that, too.
Why would they do that?
My guess is Legion. They're trying to cut NCR supply line. And the Mojave outpost is proof. Got us locked up tighter than a New Vegas virgin. No caravans in, out, and just try arguing with Jackson about it. Roads aren't safe, he says. No shit, you washed out old fuck-up. I didn't need a Brotherhood scribe to tell me that.
Who's Jackson? Jackson.
NCR officer, trooper, whatever, runs the place. He's over in the main building, the one without a bar. Jackson won't let me head north. It's not safe. And even though my caravan's gone, my caravan papers are keeping me here. So if you came here for work, my advice? Go find the Crimson Caravan branch south of Vegas. They can help you out.
I want to talk about ask you something else.
What's on your mind?
Hey, that's one of the songs. I don't know. I guess I'll be going.
Watch out!
Well, this ain't in the wrong building.
You lost?
I'm not lost.
Caravan, citizen, pilgrim, or...
courier.
Just need something for the logbook. Keeping tabs on traffic throughout the outpost. Or mostly just in, not out these days. If you're looking for the commanding officer, he's in the back. Although, he's got a lot on his plate, so if you speak with him, keep it short. Also, if you need any gear checked, we can get you up and running again. Once you fill out the work orders and sign for the parts, of course.
Anything I can do to help around here?
Help? Oh, well, you could speak to Ranger Jackson. He might have something for you. He sort of runs things around here. Mostly ends up sending reports back west that aren't filled with the best news.
I guess I'll go talk to
Sir.
Jackson. Wait, where is he? Am I supposed to talk to him?
Back again?
Well, I need to talk to you about Primm, oh yeah.
Primm? These units are stationed up there. We're having problems with some of the NCRCF convicts. What can I help you with?
Hayes is undermanned and is requesting additional support.
I'd like to help. We can't spare any more units. We have to maintain a minimum headcount at the outpost. Orders from the west.
Having Primm and the trade route under NCR control would help the rest. West.
I see the wisdom in that. I'll radio for a unit to head up to Primm and offer some additional support.
Hey.
Sir.
Goodbye. Now I need to... Now I just want to hear about... Talk to the guy.
Hey.
There you are.
Looks like we got a new visitor in the old Brahmin pen. Not many people coming here in a hurry. Only passing through. And if you're passing through, you picked a bad time. Road north has gone to hell, and if I let a caravan through, they won't make it.
Any way I can help?
Help? Now look, I appreciate... you know what? Yes, I could use the help. You look like you can handle yourself. I need to get the caravans moving again. That means clearing a path north. There's too much crawling the asphalt up the road to allow it.
Sounds like a deal.
Thanks, I appreciate it.
Guess I'll be clearing out that, I think he said the overpass? In Ivanpa Lake. Wait, one quest up. Of course I can't teleport anywhere closer. Just ignore the whatever that was over there.
Hello.
Surprisingly, I think this is still a really pretty game. Well, I mean, it's not pretty as in beauty, but it's pretty as in, like, I don't know, I kind of like how everything looks, you know? Makes you feel like you're in a post-apocalyptic wasteland. With just enough cheer for everyone to continue surviving. Not a lot, just a little. Just like how back in the olden days when people... that scared me. Just like back in the olden days, when you were out lonely on the wastes. Well, not wastes, but lonely on the prairie. There should be two more, looks like. I hear the flies. Oh, That was harder than needed to be.
Be sure it's true when you say I love you, honey. Call. You got sense enough to know. So say it.
Hello.
Appreciate the help. Wish I had more work for you, but nothing else on the radar at the moment.
You mentioned a reward before?
No, I mentioned you might accidentally get supplied, and I meant it. Not allowed to contract mercenaries at the outpost. Still, a requisition form or two can get lost, and they're not gonna come check. So here you go, just between us.
Let's see. Ooh, extra stuff.
To the town of our free road a stranger.
Ooh, this would be good.
Hardly spoke to folks around him, didn't have
patrol.
Ooh, I got a new rifle.
No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his heel.
I got a new rifle,
when he rode into the town. He came riding from the south side, slowly looking
down. This is the book.
He's an outlaw loose and running.
Ooh, I'm gonna be using this thing a lot.
And he's here to do some business with the big iron on his hip.
You know what? Before I leave this place.
In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas Red. Many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead. He was vicious and a killer, though a youth of 24, and the notches on his pistol numbered 1 in 19 more. 1 in 19 more. Now the stranger started talking.
Don't get stuck, don't get stuck.
Was an Arizona Ranger.
That's scary.
Too long in town. He came here to take an outlaw back alive or maybe dead. And he said it didn't
matter. He looks better during the day, actually.
After Texas Red.
It's starting to run a little long. Hope you will forgive me, but it's about that time of the episode, folks. If you liked it, give it a like, and this has been Flat Cap Gaming. Please subscribe, please. Bye!